Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand and remove your covers and join me in a moment of silence. At this time, we'd like to remember and recognize our veterans and military for their service here at home and overseas. Thank you. Please direct your attention to the southeast corner of the field and the playing of our national anthem by Lebanon High School Marching Pioneers. To honor America, our national anthem.
Okay, you want to go? Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Tommy Bryant Stadium here on the campus of Lebanon Middle School, where tonight the Pioneers will host the visiting John Battle. Lebanon coming in undefeated, I think they're 4-0. John Battle yet to win a game, so they're probably 0-4. Pioneers dressed in the black jerseys, white pants tonight. John Battle in white jerseys with green pants. And you're watching the toss here before the opening kickoff. Not sure what happened. He did toss the coin, but we'll have to wait on the results. By the way, I'm Jamie Farley. I'll be doing the audio. Dr. Ernie Benko is on the video here tonight. Battle won the toss, and they have deferred to the second half. So the Pioneers will receive the kickoff defending the West goal. So Lebanon will go on offense first of all. We don't have any lights on yet. I hope the lights are working. Yeah, I believe they've been turned on. I see them starting to fire up over there.
Definitely has an arm. led London Pioneers, the undefeated London Pioneers. So,
Drew Eads will kick off. He's number 17 for battle. He sets it up on the near hash mark. Dalton Long, one of the deep receivers for the Pioneers.
The kick is up and away, and that one is a nice kick for the freshman back to the 15.
Nice kick. Caught on the 15, back up the middle.
Number 14, Boyd. Hayden Boyd on return. He's going to bring it up to the 27-yard line of the Pioneers. Stopped by.
He is stopped at the 27-yard line. It'll be first and 10 Pioneers.
Ball number 14.
Mike Reese, the quarterback for the Pioneers.
It'll be first and 10 for the Pioneers.
Lane Jesse, the running back. Pioneers line up with four wide receivers. Quick toss out here on the side. That's caught up the sideline. There's Caden Boyd.
14.
Boyd with a nice gainer.
Caden Boyd. It will be complete. Knock out of bounds by number 33, Drake Hauser.
At the 39-yard line, so that's enough for a first down for the Pioneers.
First and 10 from the 39-yard line.
Reese quick pass out to Jesse out of the backfield. He's up the right side.
Michael Reese pass to the
goes out of bounds.
On
about the battle 45-yard line. We're going to spot him, I think, on the 47.
Now number 14, Childress. That'll be enough to move the chains. The foul will be set on the
first down to the Pioneers, who are going quickly. Quick pitch to Jesse. He's heading to the sideline here. Cuts up and bumped out of bounds inside
number
the 35-yard line.
Lane Jesse on the carry.
They're going to mark him down at the battle 34-yard line.
Stop by number 33, Hauser. That'll be enough to move the chains. It'll be first and 10 Pioneers from the 34-yard line of the Trojans.
Quick pass out, short gain.
Pass to number 14,
Caden Boyd made the catch.
For about three, brought down by number one.
Short gainer though, and it'll be second down
and about
seven.
About seven.
We're just underway, and we're glad you joined us here on ARC TV for high school football. Toby Baker and his wide receiver mark, and he gets it inside the 20.
Number 11, Toby Baker on the carry. Brought down by number 8, Caden Dean.
About the 18-yard line, I think.
That'll be enough for another Pioneer first down. It'll be first and 10 Pioneers inside the 20-yard line.
Reese had a man wide open in the end zone, couldn't find him. Well, he's still on his feet. He's going to get it down close to the 15-yard line.
Reese is going to work his way up for a gain of about 2 yards before he's brought down by number 66, Rush.
Baker was wide open down in the end zone. Reese under a little pressure there, couldn't see him. So it'll be second and 8 for the Pioneers. And throw to the right and goes wide.
Pass falls incomplete. Flag on the play.
We've got a flag over on the far side. Pioneers had a couple of receivers over there.
Pass interference. Yeah. It's going to be pass interference on the offense.
That's offensive pass interference is called. I'm not sure. That's a 15-yard penalty. I'm just going to take the ball all the way back to about the 32 yard.
Replay second down. It's going to be second down in a bunch for the Pioneers.
I'd say it's second down about 21, maybe 22. Reese hits Boker in the middle of the field. He dodges one, but cuts back, and he can take it all the way into the end zone.
Number 11, Toby Baker, he's in with a Pioneer touchdown.
31 yards for a touchdown, and that puts the Pioneers up 6-0. Hunter King out for the extra point. Really nice run by Baker after catching the short pass. He cut back against the grain and just eluded every battle tackler. Good snap, the kick's up.
That's why he played it. It's good.
9:56 remaining here in the first quarter. 7-0, the Pioneers lead it. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Hunter Norris, the head coach for the Pioneers. Jake Hess, head coach for John Batten. I didn't mention them. And the kick bounces into the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
In the end zone for a touchback.
Battle, the ball out to the 20-yard line. Caden Sturgill, the quarterback for Battle. He'll be number one. That looks like they're lining up in a wing T. Two of the backs, each outside the end. Man goes in motion, pitch back.
Number 33.
That was Hunter Reynolds.
Stop by number 5, Stevenson.
Picks up about 5-6 yards. We'll call it second.
Gain
of
about
4.
Five. It'll be second at about 5.
I don't think
once again, Sturgill, under center. Owen Stalker in there behind him. Same play.
Number 33.
Hunter Reynolds with that carry. He's knocked out of bounds. Just shy of the 30-yard line, so it'll be third and about a yard.
That's Reynolds. Gain of about 4. It'll be third and about 1.
Our roster has changed everything.
Both plays for Battle have been running off their right tackle. Quick handoff to Stalker, who's kind of in the fullback position, and he's met behind the line of scrimmage. He's going to usually lose a couple of yards.
Behind the line of scrimmage.
So it'd be fourth and 2 now for Battle.
It's going to be fourth on
the
line
of 2. Looks like Battle might try to go for it here. Maybe try to draw the Pioneers offside. I'm not sure.
They will. Sturgill rolls right.
Turgeon's
going for it. Watches it.
And that pass intercepted.
That pass will be intercepted by number 13, Elijah Cook, for a Pioneer first and 10.
He's tackled out, I think, about the 46-yard line off Battle.
Set it up after the
And they pioneer football on the Trojan side of the field. First and 10 from the 46-yard line.
Reach back to throw again. He's trying to.
Be sure to set your DVRs. That could be on the ESPN.
Oh, it's on the 12-yard line, so big game. What a catch by Baker. There's a pitch to Jesse. He's trying to go wide. Cuts back. And then he gets down around the 5-yard line.
Number 44, Lane Jesse on the carry. Stopped by number 18, Cunningham.
We're going to mark him inside the 5-yard line.
Gain of about 9. It'll
pick
be
up
9 yards.
And
one.
Second and one. Pioneers. Went in motion. Illegal motion, so that'll cost Pioneers 5 yards. That'll make it second down and 6. Seven nothing. The Pioneers lead at 6:45 to go first quarter. Hands it to Jesse, and he gets hit quickly. I think the ball might have come out.
The ball is going to be on the turf. It's going to be recovered by the Trojans. It will be first and 10, John Battle.
So John Battle recovers the fumble.
It's about the 7-yard line.
Jesse ran into the hard hit there. I could hear the thud from the field. That ball popped out, and Battle recovers. They'll have it, I think, on about their own 6 or 7 yard line. But anyway, it'll be first and 10. Look like from their own 6 yard line. Quarterback keeps it. Gets it out around the 10 yard line. That was Sturgill. And he'll get out to just shy of the 10-yard line.
By Luke Garrett. Game of about 4. It's going to be second and a long 6.
Looks more like second and 7 to me. But whatever.
Number 18, Cunningham on the carry.
Cunningham, okay, he was the runner.
Picks
up a
third and about 4.
About 3 yards there. We'll call it third and 4.
Shot number 15, Hernandez.
5:20 to go here, first quarter. 7-0, the Pioneers lead. Second,
and now they will pass.
Quarterback keeper, he gets outside. And
Sergio on the keeper.
He should have enough for the first down. Picks up, looks like about 6 or 7
by
yards.
82, Luke Garrett. That will be enough for a first down. It will be first and 10 Trojans from their own 19-yard line.
So he gets it out to the 19. It's first down and 10 for John Battle.
Sturgill
takes a pitch to his back in motion. And he's thrown for a loss. We've got a flag on the play, too, so we'll wait and see what happens here.
Number 68, O'Vara, first one in. It's going to be holding against the Trojans.
Holding penalty against John Battle. That'll take it back to the 10-yard line, I think. So it'll be first and 10 for Battle.
That'll be marked off half the distance. Looks like it'll be about first and about 19.
Get 10 on the play clock here. Battle's
going
to have to hurry. 5 on the play clock. Players just standing there.
It's going to
be
Trojan timeout on the field.
Timeout called by John Battle. 4:29 to go first quarter. It's 7-0. The Pioneers leading. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. All right, first and about 20 there for John Battle. Ball resting right on their 10-yard line. Or maybe it's on the 9. I can't really see those lines too well. Pitch to the back. He's coming wide. And he breaks loose. And ran him down, but he broke loose for a fine game.
It'll be first and 10 Trojans from the Pioneer 38-yard line.
Under center, timeout,
Coach Hess
again.
And Battle takes another timeout. 4:05 left here, first quarter. 7-0, the Pioneers lead it. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Okay, after the big run, Battle takes the timeout. So they've got first and 10 on the Pioneers 38-yard line after a long run.
Sturgill gets the snap, play fake, rolls right with it, going to be a design QB keeper to the
30. Number one, Sturgill on the keeper, brought down by number seven.
Down to about 34. Battle running about everything to the Pioneers' left side. Picked up, I don't know, about 5 yards on that carry. It'll be second.
Gain about 4. It'll be second and about 6.
Gives it to his up back.
Number 6.
That's Owen Stopper.
Stopper on the carry. Number 44, Lane Jesse.
Well, no gain on the play.
No gain on the play. It'll be third and about 6.
Number 33,
Hauser on the carry. Stop by number 13, Elijah Cook.
Reynolds all the time.
That will be enough for a first down.
It'll Reynolds first is the one that made the long run earlier, too, I'm pretty sure.
24-yard line.
The ball was after 24, and that will be first and 10 for Battle.
$15 on the play clock. Sturgill under center
now.
John Battle
stops
on the backfield.
Yeah.
Sturgill, it's the snap.
Slater fakes the catch. He's
going to
keep it.
Number one, Sturgill on the carry. Down by number eight, Dalton Hess.
Hess with the tackle for the right there. Might have lost just a little bit.
Lost about a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
Minute 30 to go in the first. 10 on the play clock. Sturgill is under center for John Battle. Now down to 5 on the play clock. 4 on the play clock. Sturgill. Motion
to
man, gets the snap, just inside.
Battle tried to run a reverse there, and the runner, quarterback collided with each other, and that one didn't go so well for Battle. Marked the butt back on the 30-yard line, so that was a loss there of about 5 yards. It's going to be third and...
Number 68, O'Hara.
15 or 16.
They've got a marker behind the line of scrimmage. That's a loss of about 5.
And now Sturgill under center gets the snap. Hands, that's going to be Hauser. Hauser cuts up, goes trying to break through a few tackles.
Number 33, Hauser is going to be brought down by number 8.
Hauser. Short yardage for Battle. It's going to be fourth down.
Brought down by number 8, Dalton Hess. It's going to bring up fourth and long for the Trojans.
That'll went far back in their own territory. I'm sure they'll go four downs here. Ball at the Pioneer 27.
And nobody's going to run out.
That's the end of the first quarter, ladies and gentlemen.
That is the first quarter. 7-0, the Pioneers lead it after a quarter. We're back for second quarter action. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. All right, it'll be fourth and long for Battle, fourth and 13, from the Pioneer 27-yard line. Sturgill pitches it back to the Omen's area.
Number 33, Hauser on the carry.
That was Hauser, no, that was Reynolds that carried down. And he stopped way short of a first down, so the Pioneers stopped that drive by John Battle.
Yeah, definitely trying to hold the ball.
Will be first and 10 Pioneers.
Take over, I think, on their own
31-yard line.
Hands off number 11. He's
going
to try to go left side.
I think
that's
Baker.
Number 11, Baker on the carry.
Not much there.
I think they say he gets
expected to get
line.
Stop by number 72.
I still can't tell exactly where that ball is. No gain on the play. It'll be second and 10 for the Pioneers. Reese in the shotgun, lays it out here to the right. That ball is caught by Kate Boyd.
Complete. Shot by number 1, Sturgill.
Boss Martin on the 25-yard line. It's third and about 8 for the Pioneers. Reese has it looking. He throws it long down the field. He's got a man open on Baker, but he overthrew him. threw it too long.
Breeze passed the Baker, falls incomplete.
So it's fourth and long for the Pioneers, and I wouldn't be surprised if they don't kick.
So it'll be fourth down and about seven for the Pioneers.
Looks like Caden Sturgill would back in safety there for John Batten. Toby Baker, the punter there for the Pioneer. Pioneers have to take a timeout as they had a man short, and the play clock was about to run out on them.
Timeout, Pioneers.
Pioneers huddle up quickly and they're back out on the field. And they will go into punt formation. Ball's resting, I think, right on the 25-yard line of the Pioneers. Sturgill going back there. Also looks like Caden Dean, a double safety. Good snap. Low kick. And the ball comes loose. Sturgill tried to shoestring it. Couldn't catch it, but fell right on it. So Battle will take over on their own 48-yard line. First and 10. 10:45 left here, first half. It's 7-0. Pioneers are leading.
From their own 51-yard line.
And we've got a whistle and a flag.
Dead ball, flag on the play.
Illegal motion by Battle. So that play really doesn't count, but it'll cost Battle 5 yards.
Ball start, excuse me, on the Trojans to be first and 15.
Ball's at the Battle 44-yard line.
The Sturgill here now in under center here from the 44. Third one of the Sturgill. Gets the snap. Big pitch there, Sturgill.
Sturgill faces the pitch.
Forward progress.
He stood up right on Robert Stevenson.
Stevenson.
They're going to mark it back at the 44-yard line of Battle. He's going to lose about 5 or 6 yards on the way.
15.
So it'll be second, looks like 16.
It's a snap, which is out to Enders. Enders tries to break through and get the game about the whistle.
Number 25, Enders, on the carry, behind the number 78, Hunter Cox.
Gain of about a yard. It's going to be third and 15 for Battle.
Of about a yard.
Ball resting on about over 45-yard line.
Trojans
go back
under
center
with 9:21
to
second, quarter, 3rd and 14 on their own 45.
Sturgill
gets the snap.
Oh, they're colliding in the backfield again. They tried to run a misdirection. That's the second time that the quarterback and the back have collided. So just a short game.
Timeout on the field.
We got an injured Trojan. I think that was the ball carrier.
Yeah, that would be number 33, so we'll take a break.
That was Hunter Reynolds, who's been the main runner there for Battle, and I believe he's got a cramp. But anyway, while they tend to him, we'll take a break. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
All right, welcome back here as the Trojans are going to get ready to punt.
Looks like Cunningham will do the punting there for.
It'll be fourth and about 13 for the Trojans.
Look, that's Toby Baker back. Well, I'm not sure who's back there. I can't see the number. Sidewinder catches it. Catching it. That makes a nice move. Leads up the sideline. Still going.
Number 15, Hernandez will take the distance. Flag on the play.
We got a flag way back up the field, so I think that's just. Or not. That's a long, exciting run, but it's not going to count. Flag's back at the Pioneer 40-yard line.
Gonna be legal block in the back by the Pioneers. That would be a spot foul. Marked off 10 yards from the point of the
That's
foul.
A 10 yard penalty. That'll take the ball back inside the 30 yard line. Pioneers will have it first and 10. We've got 8:29 to go here in the first half.
Timeout, Trojans.
In Battle takes the timeout. That'll be all they get this half. That's their third timeout. So.
There's chili beans
and stuff already on the field. Okay. Hey, hey, hey. 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 Hey, hey.
Tell them. Curtis Boston, you make sure they get back. Ladies and gentlemen, there has been a set of AirPods found, Florida Gator AirPods. If you can believe it, Florida Gator AirPods. If you also go to the gate down behind the goalposts, they have those AirPods.
All right, first and 10 Pioneers. At least looking. Near an interception. Tried to hit Baker with that one. He was covered up really well by Elijah Childress. In fact, I thought Childress was going to pick that one off.
Number 11.
So it'll be second and 10 for the Pioneers. Pitch to Jesse, and he nearly loses his feet, but keeps his feet.
Number 44, Lane Jesse on the
carry. 35 to the 36, a nice game by Jesse. I think he'd have picked up more than that if he could have kept his feet. Third and about two. Trying to hit Caden Boyd coming across there and just missed him.
Reese the boy incomplete.
So it's fourth down, about two for the Pioneers.
Fourth and about two for the Pioneers.
Looks like Coach Norris decided he's going for it here. Deep in Pioneer territory. Gives it to Jesse. He's got a good hold. He bursts through and gets up around the 45
yard line. Jesse on the carry.
Nice hold there, though, by the Pioneer lineman.
Stop by number 14, Childers. That'll be enough to move the chains. It'll be first and 10, Pioneers.
Reese drop looking. Can't find anybody. He cuts up the middle. Gets over the midfield strike and down to the battle 40.
Number 10, Reese on the carry.
5 yard line. He's going to be just shy of a first down.
He'll pick up about 9.5.
Picks up 9 on the scramble.
And about a yard.
Second and a yard. Reese throws it out in the flat. That's Caden Boyd. And Boyd knocked out of bounds after a good game.
Number 10, Reese pass to number 14. Caden Boyd complete.
He's tackled down at the John Battle 30-yard line, I think. It'll be first and 10 for the Pioneers. They're just inside.
Well, down to number 8, Dean.
Reese looking at the pass again. He's got Baker in the end zone. Perfect pass.
Indeed.
It drops right into Toby.
He's in for the Pioneer touchdown.
Nice throw there by Mike Reese. Baker got open and he laid it in there nicely. So that makes the score 13-0 in favor of the Pioneers. And King in to try for the extra point.
The extra point is him here coming.
Toby Baker, the holder.
King, snap the set, the kick.
Gets it down, the kick's up, and he looks to the man. So 14-0, the Pioneers lead it. 6:55 to go here in the first half. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Hunter King ready to kick off now from the Pioneer. Kicks it fairly high, hits the ground, picks up on about the 10-yard line.
Has to run right, goes 15.
Number 33, Hauser on the
run. That was really.
Stop by number 15, Hernandez.
He goes down on about the 17-yard line.
The half
trade
looking to drive here, make it back to a
one-score
game.
Number 32, Easton Taylor, also in on the
action.
We're going to provide everybody the live slug now has live bait in the concession stand. Minnows, $9, we're in Wrigley's.
Ball's at the, I believe the 17-yard line, maybe the 18. We'll call it the 18. Batter have it first and 10.
It's the snap, and fake pitch out to Dean there. Starts
to
run down way behind the line.
Virgil on carry.
And it's going to be a second down ball. No big loss there. It's about 5 seconds.
Stop by number 40, Kinder.
You can throw him down.
Yeah, they got it right. So it'll be second and 15.
I think that was Fry that got that tackle. About a 3 or 4 yard loss.
Second quarter. It'll be Sturgill up under center for John Battle. Sturgill. Under center. Pushing the man in the backfield. It's the snap. They handed it off there.
It's center. The old center keeper.
And that will be a gain of about 3. It's going to be third. About 12.
The old center keeper.
think that was Stocker who carried that one.
All back from the olden days, caught by number 15, Hernandez.
We'll be third and about 12 for a battle.
It'll be Sturgill under center. Sturgill under center. Back in the backfield. Gets a snap. Ahead in the pitch. Now looks, avoids pressure. Throws it deep downfield. Childress is open.
What a catch. That was a great catch by Childress. That's a Pioneer 40-yard line. He was wide open.
That's another ESPN top 10 for tonight.
That's a Pioneer 43-yard line, looks like.
First and 10 play, gets the snap. It's back to Hauser. Hauser breaks through.
Hauser's got it. Good yardage on the first down. Battles gained most of their yardage tonight, running to the right. Picks up, looks like about 4 yards on that carry. It'll be second and 6. Balls inside the 40-yard line.
It's the snap. Pitches back out to Hauser.
Hauser in motion again.
He's on the carry.
Close to the 35-yard line where he stood up.
Stop by number 68. Olvera.
Look like the ball was on the Pioneer 37-yard line. It's going to be third and 6 yards to go for our first down. Quarterback keeps it and he gets it down to the 35-yard line.
Stop by number 7.
It's going to be 4th and about 5.
Dalton Long. Timeout Pioneers.
And Lebanon takes the timeout. They lead it 14-0. 3:16 left here in the first half. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. All right, big play here for Battle. 4th down to about 5. At the Pioneer 36-yard line. They trail it 14-0, so they need to pick up this first down.
That
was good coverage.
Sturgill
by Hernandez as the quarterback.
Number 15, Hernandez.
He's short of the first down, so the Pioneers will take over on their own 35-yard line.
From their own 35-yard line.
Pioneers lined up this time. They have wide receivers. Two to the left, one to the right. Quick pass out there. The receiver has to go down on his knees to catch it. That was Caden Boyd, and he's going to lose a couple of yards.
Boyd complete. It'll be a loss of about 2. It'll be second and about 12.
2:45 going, counting in. The coach has a no timeout select. The Norris should have one. Raising the shotgun. Good left, two right, raising the second one. Looks, throws, wide open man. right side complete. Trying to break through.
Pass out here to Luke Garrett, I think. Garrett catches it and goes out of bounds.
Green pass to number 82, Luke Garrett, complete.
Picks up about 4 yards.
Brought down by number one, Sturgill, to be third at about 7.
Race lays it out there and he's got it in. Goodness. Luke Garrett, wide open. 62 yards. Flag on there. I'm not sure what he called.
We have a dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct against the Pioneers. Touchdown is good.
I guess the Pioneers celebrated a little bit in the end zone. I didn't see what went on. But the referee threw that flag from about 60 yards away, so yeah. Pioneers did something they shouldn't do. They'll penalize them on the kickoff, I think.
He told him he didn't tell him to go over there.
For the touchdown, and King will try for the extra point.
The snap is set, the kick is up, the kick is...
King's kick is up. Extra point good. That makes it 21-0 in favor of the Pioneers. I don't think the Pioneers will have to kick off from their own 25-yard line. Pioneer kicker King paced off the penalty. I don't believe I've seen that before. He will be kicking off from his own 25 yard line.
And then battling about 59, it will be Hauser and here we go. King kicking. Minute 59 to go until half. Battle gets to the block. The kick is up and away. That one is received by Sturgill. He gets it 25. Sturgill 30. Sturgill 35. Sturgill tries to break through a few tackles. He gets to the.
I thought Sturgill dropped to a knee when he caught that kickoff. It was pretty close. But anyway, he gets it out to almost to the 40-yard line, where Battle will have it first and 10. They've got no timeouts left, only a minute 52 left here in the first half. So even though they've got good starting field position now, I don't. Don't have much time to take advantage of that field position.
17 on the play clock. Sturgill to Chips. Under 7. 10 on the play clock. Line gets set. Sturgill with power. Gets the snap. Pitches out. That's number 18. Cunningham gets up to about the 8-yard line.
Cunningham on a carry.
Cunningham picks up about 3 yards. Battle lines up quickly.
Gets the snap, pitches back to Cunningham. Flags come in.
I thought I heard a
whistle. Flags for the false start against the Trojans. We get second down. It'll be second down at about 12.
That did not look like they were set, and when that ball is snapped, it does not look like Battle's ready to hurry at all. So it'll be second and 11. here from the 37. Minute 24 to go in the second quarter. Clock is running. Battle with Sturgill under center. I did as well. Sturgill gets the snap. Gonna try to do a QB keeper. He's gonna
Keeps it. Makes a couple pretty nice moves there. Gets it back up to the 40.
Sergeant on carry.
The
clock is moving. We're inside a minute here now. Third down on about 9 for the battle.
Gets a snap, pitches back to Cunningham.
Cunningham's got it, gets outside. Gets up to about the 45 yard line.
Winner on the carry, stop by.
To go in the second, timeout
by number one, Mabry.
And the Pioneers take a timeout, I believe that.
Timeout, Pioneers.
It'll be first, fourth down, about 3 for battle. 21-0, Pioneers lead it. 41 seconds left here in the first half.
So
the Pioneers stop the clock in case they can get the ball back. The battle's got a 4th and 3. They can retain possession here if they get the first down. So.
Gets the snap, pitches out number 25, and he's stuck. He will not get the first down. And
Caden Dean with a really good tackle.
Not happy with the way it went. The first and down behind you, 35 seconds.
And the ball turned over here.
Number one, Mabry.
Pioneers will get it at their own 45-yard line. They've got 35 seconds. I don't know. They may have one timeout. I'm not sure. Reese looking. He's got a man. That's Caden Boyd. He caught it. Fell down.
Reese passing number 14
inside the 20-yard line.
Complete.
Clock is stopped for the first down, and Reese spikes the ball.
Second down and 10 for the Pioneers.
Evidently, I don't think the Pioneers have any more timeouts, but they've got the balls. It'll be second down.
Folks, get your half and half tickets out ready. Get your half and half tickets out.
17 or 18 yard line. I believe it's on the 18.
Gets the snap, he just spiked it again. So now it's going to be third. Did they not get the first spot?
Reese spiked that one.
The line marker is second.
We're
working on the field goal.
All right, it'll be second and 10 for the Pioneers.
So, Reese in the shotgun. Two left, two right. Gets the snap and looks. Throws. End zone. He's got a man in the corner. Incomplete. He was out of bounds.
You see, we ran into the fence down there. I don't think he caught it.
The ball is incomplete.
I believe that's Caden Boyd that tried to knock that fence down.
You don't get on this play.
14 seconds on the clock.
30 in the shotgun formation, gets the snap. Looks. Rolls out right here.
Reese rolls to the right.
Throw it in zone.
Throws it down the paint. Battle for a ball. He's battling away.
Probably
better
than
five.
Incomplete.
Four
for
the clock's down to 7 seconds. It's fourth down and 10. King could probably kick a field goal from there, but I don't know what the Pioneers are doing.
Sorry, they're going for it.
So.
Let's get it some sugar.
Now it'll be Reese out here in the shotgun. They're going to go for one look right in the end zone with 7 on the clock until the halftime break. They're up 21-9. He gets the snap and looks. Throws. Braylon Moran on the coverage. Did he catch that football? He did.
Touchdown.
And the Pioneers score. I'm not sure who caught that pass. Time has run out, but the Pioneers will kick the extra points and untimed down. Who caught that pass, Merle?
Who caught it?
Carter.
Jesse.
Caden Jesse caught the pass. Or Lane Jesse. I couldn't really see over there. So, last play of the first half, and we're having the extra point.
Good.
We've reached the half, 28-0. The Pioneers lead John Madden. We'll be back with second half action. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
I think he ran
a paper. All right, welcome back to the second half. The Pioneers leading battle 28-0. The Pioneers received the first half kickoff, so Lebanon will kick off to John Battle here to start the second half. We're glad you joined us. I'm Jamie Farley. I'll do the audio here, and Ernie Binko is on the video. Kick caught on about the 4-yard line. Hunter coming back and a nice tackle that time.
Bowser on the third, chosen.
Nice tackle by Jack Garland.
29-yard line. Number 21, Jack Garland on the tackle.
Ball's on the 29-yard line off battle. They'll have it first and 10.
Hand off
for a quick header up the middle. Roger Cook ran that down. There was Owen Starker who broke loose up the middle and nearly took it all away. Just a little quick crap play in the middle. He burst through there. Cook was the only Pioneer that had a chance to get him. So big gainer to the Pioneer 34-yard line. Battle will have it first and 10.
Gets the snap, gets it into the backfield. The Hauser
cuts back.
Number 3-1, Hauser on the Garrett. Loose ball, Pioneer.
He loosed the ball. I have no idea who recovered it. So it'll be Pioneer football first and 10 from their own 31-yard line.
So it'll be first and 10 Pioneers from their own 31-yard line.
See, the big gainer for battle falls up short as they turn the ball over. race throws it to the sideline. It's complete, but.
Pass to number 44, Lane. Second quarter. Reese.
Out of
top
to Bowman. Left side to
Bowman. Reese.
Play from Coach Norris.
Number 7, Moran on the tackle.
Right.
Lost about a yard.
Play was complete for a loss of a yard. Second and 11.
30-yard line.
Not sure who copped that pass. It'd have been better off dropping it. Quick pass out here to Baker. He'll lose one tackler. Spins around, gets it up here in midfield before he's taken it down. So big gainer for the Pioneer. Picks up the first down.
48-yard line before he's ran out of bounds by number 8, Caden Dean.
Gets the snap and looks, throws out right side.
Reese throws it behind the receiver.
Incomplete. Second and 10 from the 48-yard line.
Trying to hit Caden Boyd out there and kind of threw that one behind him. So incomplete pass, it'll be second and 10 for the Pioneers.
Hand
off to Jesse. And he plows through there for a big gainer.
Number 44, Lane on Jerry.
Looks like he picks up 4 or 5.
Oh, man, I'm sorry, I don't have a name.
Call it 3rd and 4.
Gets the snap. Looks, throws. Short little screen pass out.
Quick pass.
He's going to get out.
Caden Boyd catches it, scoots up the field.
Caden Boyd on reception.
He's pretty close to a first down. In fact, he got it.
Brought down by number 14, Childress. First down Pioneers.
Quick pass out here for Boyd. He didn't catch that one.
Pass to number 14, Boyd, incomplete.
So it'll be 2nd and 10 for the Pioneer.
Reese
looking deep downfield. That one's overthrown.
Pass incomplete.
He was looking for knuckles that time.
Caden Dean on the defense.
Two left, two right.
We'll bring up 3rd and 10 for the Pioneers.
3rd and 10 for the Pioneers.
43-yard line.
Looks, here comes the pressure.
Race across the middle, that was
Baker, incomplete.
Baker left his feet trying to catch that one, but unable to come down with it.
Cunningham on the defense.
So, 4th and 10 for the Pioneers. Just barely into battle territory. I don't know where they're
going. Bring up 4th and long.
Well, they'll go for it here or punt it. I believe Coach Norris there is going to go for it here at 4th and 10. Reese lays it out right side, and I think that was caught. It was down close to the 20-yard line.
Number 44, Lane Jesse on the section.
Lane Jesse coming out of the backfield and running the circle. Caught that one for a nice gain. So 4th and 10.
Moran.
Pioneers get a first down.
It'll be 1st and 10 Pioneers from the 23-yard line.
Looks, throws, and middle of the field, caught by number 14, brought down by
Perkins.
Reese to Boyd, complete.
Caden Boyd makes the catch.
Number 25,
Henders. Second and 4,
official timeout on the field.
Got an injury timeout there. It'll be second down and about three or four for the Pioneers. Injured man off the field, so the official calling both teams back out to continue to play. Ball's located on the 16-yard line of battle. Reese Lewis.
Reese, the number four,
Knuckles with the touchdown. Anderson Knuckles.
Now drive to the point.
Threw that one into a little bit of traffic, but Knuckles darted in there and caught it and scored. 34-0, Pioneers lead it now, and Keene will try for another extra point.
And now on our 29, that is going to be Keene, going to get the extra point.
Pioneers 35-0. The Pioneers lead it. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. Right, King ready to kick off once again.
King kicking.
He kicks it to the corner. Picks up on about the 5-yard line. Pretty effective kick. Not going to be tackled there on about the 15-yard line.
Number 13, Cook, for the first and 10 Trojans, from the 16-yard line.
Quick hand off to the up back. Not much cooking there.
Number 33, Howell's on the carry. He's going to be dropped by number 41, Cody Fry. And number 40, Tanner Kendrick. No gain on the play. It'll be second and about 10.
Just a snap. And we'll hand off this one at number 18. Cunningham will stuff it and line in.
Cunningham on the carry. He's going to be dropped by number 5, Robert Stevenson.
Stevenson with a good defensive play that time.
Gain of about a yard.
It's going to be third and nine for a battle.
And a short nine.
And now,
Battles takes time out. We'll take it with them. It's 35-0 in favor of the Pioneers. You're listening to or watching high school football on ARC TV. All right, third and long for battle.
Sturgill's
a big gainer, but we've got a flag on the play.
Which is outbound by number 5, Stevenson, flag on the play. So we're holding against the Trojans.
And that'll cost the John Battle half the distance to the goal. Too bad, a good play there by Sturgill, but most time most holding calls are what springs that runner loose anyway. I think that's mostly why they throw the flag.
So it'll be marked off half the distance, clock will roll.
So it's going to be third down, like about 17. One good thing about it, with the way the score is spread out, the clock runs pretty much full time, so. Big tackle there by Robert Stevenson on the
Hauser on carry.
Hauser was carrying off. And Toby Baker going back, because this is a punting situation for the back.
Fernandez. So it'll be fourth and a bunch for the Trojans as they line up in punt formation.
Bunt hits on about the 40, and it's going to roll dead. That's the John Battle 49-yard
line. We first and 10 pioneers from the Trojan 49-yard line.
Touchdown. Pioneers go up 41 to nothing.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hate to say it, it's going to be another top 10 SPN reel for tonight's broadcast.
It's 42-0. The Pioneers lead it. 3:38 to go third quarter. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
All right, it's 42-0 Pioneers over Trojans with King the Kick. Over Johnson, London, actually Sturgill and Alvin. Dean Dickey here.
King ready now to kick off. Caught on about the 7-yard line.
Sturgill
carries it out to about the 30-yard line. We're back. We'll have it first and 10.
Easton Taylor on the tackle.
right on that.
That's 31. Ball being placed on the 31-yard line. Will it be first and 10, Chargers?
Running, having to run a play early on battle, they will bust the play clock up. Now they'll roll it. Now, snap, they'll pitch it back out to Hauser. Hauser trying to find his blocker. Tries to break three for a couple of
minutes. That was Hauser. Picks up short yardage. Like picks up a couple of yards. It'll be second down and eight.
Game about two, it'll be second, about eight.
Somebody got him from behind there that time on the bench.
Hauser on the carry.
It's like Kobe Fry.
Caught from behind by number 41, Kobe Fry.
And we got a battle player down on the field.
Official timeout on the field. Folks, they have a few more horny head biscuits at the concession stand. They're on half price.
So that'll cost them 5 yards.
It'll be a dead ball. Play on the way. It's going to be a false start against the Trojans.
Here we go. Now we're talking.
So it'll be third and about 14 now.
26, here we go. 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. We'll have to write at least one more play here in the quarter.
He got looked for longer than a second.
He's gone outside. Now, Sergio under center. Gets the snap. Pitches back out to Cunningham in the backfield. Cunningham
on Jerry. Stop for no gain. That'll make it fourth.
Number 9, Paul Morrison on the tackle. Loss of about four. This will be fourth down and about 14 for the Trojans as we begin the fourth
That's
quarter.
Going to be the end of the third quarter after three quarters of play. 42-0, 11-0 battle. You're watching high school football on ARC TV. All right, it's fourth and long for battle. It looks like they're going to line up in punt formation, though. It looks like they're going for it.
Fourth and 14, Trojans going for it. Down
42-0,
they pitch it back out to Hauser.
Hauser
trying to
pitch out to Hauser,
and
he picks up
5 or 6. That won't be enough. The ball
will be way short, so
the first and 10.
Pioneers will take over on the battle
Number 79,
30 yards
in on that tackle.
So it'll be Pioneer football. Not sure what kind of changes coach will make. He needs to. I don't think he's got near enough out there.
All right, Reese, they ran another one. Yeah, they're going to call timeout.
Timeout 11 to 10:45 on the fourth.
Timeout, Pioneers.
Actually, we'll keep it here. I don't know.
Pioneers take a timeout. We'll take it with them. They lead 42 to nothing here. 10:45 remaining in the game. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
It's the snap. We'll hand it to number 8, who goes left side.
Number 8, Dalton Hess.
Oh, McCurry. Doesn't get much.
Loss of about a yard.
Will
be second. About 11 for the Pioneers. Number 9, Morrison on the carry.
Cole Morrison.
Stop by number 55, Allison. Loss of 1, number 3rd, and about 12.
3rd and 12 for the Pioneers.
Reese comes back in with the play. On 3rd and about 12, climbed the Trojan
32. You wonder if they tried it back there, even though they're up 2 right, 2 left. Reese in the shotgun, gets the snap, and they do. Oh, my God!
Where did he come from?
Reese dropped back to pass, and
here. Pancake, that's a 40. Reese for a loss of about 8.
Yeah, that
one's all him coming.
And so the punting squad will come out. Baker will punt.
Pioneers
are going to punt Baker. Looking for a
punt here. On a fourth down. And very low. The punt is up and away. This one will sail out of bounds. Baker's going to run out of bounds. I don't know.
Baker will shot will roll out of bounds and mount the 15-yard line. We're in the 15-10 Trojans.
Well, we're in the neighborhood of the 15. First and 10 for battle from their own 15-yard line, I think.
And now Sturge will under center. It's the snap, motion into the backfield to Hauser. Hauser going to break, try to break a run, but he's stopped by the Pioneers.
Hauser, 4 or 5 yards there.
Shot by number 53, Jared Slate.
So it'll be second and about 4.
So now it'll be.
It'll be second along 3.
Hello.
Very cool. Now we'll pitch it back out to Cunningham, and Cunningham is wrapped up. Behind the line, and Miner got back to the line.
Third and 1 carry is going to be wrapped up by number 63.
No gain on that play. It'll be third.
No gain on the play. It'll be third.
About 4.
It's about 4.
And Third on a third, fourth play, 21. 728 Jordan County in the fourth. 5-42, John Battle 0. Gets the snap here. Third goal going to be on a design quarterback keeper. He is going to be brought down. No
quarterback will be smelly on the line of the evening. Picked up. About
inches.
3 yards. It's going to be four.
Forward progress. Oh, they are going to give him a first down.
What? First game. They're going to bring the
chain. They're going to get
first down.
First
down. First down. The battle clock. 6:46 Jones County in the fourth. Sergio. Yep. And he'll have a design QB keeper. And he will have flags coming.
The number one Sturgill on carry, flag on the play.
Secondary, and Sturgill is down. We will take a break and come
brought
back.
Down by number 21, Garland, and 32.
Holding on timeout.
Fish will turn out on the field. They're going to flag on the play. From the little knock in the back by the Trojans.
All right, we'll take a break. Injury on the field there. We'll be back. You're watching high school football on ARC TV.
And we are
going to
get back.
Okay, it'll be first and 20, I believe, for a battle.
That is going to be Dave Shipley in the backup. We're back for John Battle.
And
whistle blow,
false
start on John
Battle. Dave Shipley in the quarterback for the Trojans.
Everybody's got a lot of subs in there now. And
it is false start on Battle, so they'll back up.
A lot of times when you get these subs in there, these officials need to quit looking so close. Because they're going to go in motion and miss snap counts and all. Of course, they need to abide by the rules, but need to loosen up on the rules.
It's going to be first and about 25.
And now that one is going to be a handoff.
Here we go. Here we go. He's off to the races. He's going down the
to the 30-yard line, and it will be about a second.
Hunter Reynolds on a nice run.
Five for John Battle here.
Picks up about almost 20 yards, call it 19, and it'll be second and about six.
Number 20, Aiden Cook. We'll get about 20 yards back. It'll be second down the long five.
Now, the Trojans have Shipley under center. They'll pitch it to Cunningham. Cunningham
on the carry.
That was Cunningham, man. Short gainer. Make it third and about three.
One, Cameron Casey on the tackle.
About three.
It's like a bomb. Third down and about three for the Trojans.
Ball at 34 to go in the fourth quarter. Third goal here. Sorry, that Shipley gets the snap, pitches out to Hauser. Hauser goes 40, 45, 50, 45, 40. Off to the races, 35. That's one man to beat.
Hauser breaks the lead.
Number
33,
Hauser, he wins with a
broken
touchdown.
68 yards, I think, on that one. That was Hauser on the breakaway, and that makes it 42-6.
Number 17 for John Battle. We'll be on the extra point against Lou Meeks. Getting Dean hold.
Yeah.
The kick is on the way. The kick by
kick is up and good. 42-7. With 4:17 left in the game, you're watching high school football on ARC TV.
42-7. Trojans trailing high. Needs the kick for John Battle. 3:30.
All right, he's kicking off now. Rolls around back on about the 15-yard line.
Goes 20, 25, goes 30 down the left side and runs out of bounds. The 3:15 on County.
Number 14, Caden Boyd on the return. Ran out of bounds by number 17, Drew Eads.
There's a flag.
Yes, there is.
The flag's gonna be waved off. It'll be first and 10 Pioneers from their own 31-yard line.
He fumbles it, ball is still on the ground. Bramer picks it up, and he is going to be tackled by the Trojans number 8, Caden Dean, back in the backfield.
That's wrong, Bramer.
Bramer, the quarterback, lost the ball. I think he got up with it, but then came back with the ball, but lost about 10 yards on that one. So it'll be second down for the Pioneers.
Off the bunch. It's going to be second and a bunch.
Number 12, Kramer here at 4. They are just running the circle up in here.
Yep. First time we've been on.
They're going to go reach on his team.
There's the snap. They will run it. Kramer, the quarterback keeper.
Kramer. Picks up like about 6 or 7 yards.
Brought down on number 31. Michael Ingers.
It'll be third down and about 14 for the Pioneers. Taylor on quite a run there. Goes out of bounds at the 40-yard line of John Battle.
Number 32, Taylor on the turn.
Easton Taylor. Good run.
They stepped out of bounds on the 40-yard line.
Clock's still running. We're down to 20 seconds here. Clock is moving.
And that's a knee, and that'll do it. Your final score, 42-7-11.
Okay, he takes a knee. Ball game's over. Pioneers win it 42-7 over John Battle. Appreciate you watching. Hope you enjoyed the game. 42-7, our final score. For Ernie Binkar and Jamie Farley, wishing everyone a good evening. This has been a sports presentation of ARC TV.